morning students, how are you? Hope you are fine and healthy. Now we shall begin our class with today's word. Word of the day. And our today's word is cephalologist. Cephalologist. It is a noun. And the first P is silent. First P is silent. Cephalologist. Any idea what does it mean? Cephalologist is a study about how people are voting. How people are voting. And cephalologist is a person, one who goes around and takes opinion polls, and as soon as the election comes to an end, now the predicts about who is likely to win the election. And this study is called as cephalology, and a person, one who does that study, is called as cephalologist. Cephalologist. And remember that pronunciation is very important. First P is silent. It is a study about how people are voting. Right? Got it? Okay. Yeah. Now our today's grammar tips. What is the difference between until and up to? Until and up to. Until or till, used with time. Used with time. For example, the students will be here till or until 5 o'clock. Right? So, until or till, both use same meaning, used with time. And a word up to is used with distance and quantity. Distance and quantity. For example, the boy runs up to the beach house. Up to the beach house. And another example is his car can carry up to 12 people. Up to 12 people. So until and up to, until or till used with time. The student will be here till or until 5 o'clock. And up to used with distance and quantity. You should not be confused. Let it be very clear. Got it? See, as I already told you, again I would like to remind you, whenever you learn a word, a new word, you must know what parts of speech it belongs to. You must know whether it is noun or adverb or adjective or preposition or article, whatever it is. And also remember that you must learn a word with its preposition. So it would be easier for you to develop your English fluency. And the very important thing is, when you learn your word, the basic steps towards learning English is that you must know the difference between noun and verb. You must know the difference between noun and verb. Because in many cases, noun and verb maybe seems same, but they are not same. See, remember one thing, once you know the difference between noun and verb, it means that you are going on a right track. Actually, you are learning English correctly. So the first step is that you must know the difference between noun and verb. Try to differentiate noun from verb. If you know this, if you can find out the difference between noun and verb, means it's good going. Okay? Yes. Take down this. Today, we shall discuss on the essay, The Evils of Dowry System. The Evils of Dowry System. The topic itself says dowry is evil. Dowry is the evil of the society. Dear students, when you go through a newspaper, definitely you come across two or three pieces of news which is related to dowry issues, Okay, before that, you might have seen, when a male boy is born, people are very happy in general, and in particular, parents are very happy. They call their relatives immediately, they call their neighbor, and they want their presents. Their face are bubbling with enthusiasm, they are very, very happy. They distribute sweets, even sometimes they organize a grand function because a male boy is born. On the other hand, if a female baby is born, for a male baby the things are totally different. For a female baby, it takes different dimension. You might have seen. Even sometimes, the parents are not at all informing their close relatives and neighbors. they keep quiet, they keep long face. The expression of dismay you can find on their faces. They are not at all happy. They look as if that they have underwent a serious tragedy in their life. You can see their faces are grief stricken. There is no smile on their faces. It is, something that someone has debt. Why it is so? Have you ever think about this? Have you ever thought of this? See, both are babies. Why it is so? Why they celebrate the birth of a male baby? Why they won't celebrate the birth of female baby? And sometimes what happens now? Sometimes what happens? The in-laws are not at all visiting hospitals to see a female baby. This is the attitude of in-laws. If your male baby is born, immediately they rush hospital. They purchase new clothes, they purchase sweets to distribute. As they receive the news that a female baby is born, they are not at all visiting the hospital. Even they don't bother about what happened to that newborn baby and your mother. The reasons could be many. The reasons could be many. But have you ever thought what may be the reason behind these things? Why it is happening? Why that male baby is considered as so superior, and why the female baby is shown in an inferior light? What's that? The reason is, our society has made a very wrong trend. Generally, our people think that if a female baby is born, for a girl, it is very difficult to marry off her. You can't marry off her. It is very difficult to get her married. Whereas if a boy is born, the things are quite different. Okay. What made them? Why it is so difficult in our society to marry off a daughter? The thing is that because our society has made it very difficult. Particularly for middle class people. See, always, you know, that is the suffering class. The suffering class of the society is middle class society. For rich people, no problem. They have got enough money, they are so wealthy, they are highly influenced in the society that, you know, they marry off their daughters, no problem in it. They have got influence, they have got money, they have got power, they get whatever they want. And what is the condition of the poor? No problem. They too seek some sources so that they can marry off their daughters. But the thing is, the always a suffering section in our society is a middle class section. Middle class people, you know, they live with dignity, they die with dignity. Even if they are hungry, they won't express, they won't disclose that I am hungry. They never extend their hands. They never seek help from others because they try to do on their own. Because for them, you know, dignity is their breath of their life. Till they breathe their last, they live with dignity. And the thing is that when a female child is born, they think that they feel that it is a burden on their shoulders. A female baby is a burden on their female on their shoulders, because they think that how I am going to marry off my daughter. What is the reason? Because we make marriages a very tedious one. Because in our society we have got so many unnecessary rituals, and the totally, you know, if you ask me, I would say that rich people should be blamed for this. Because marriage is a simple affair. Marriage is a simple affair. But the rich people, you know, they have set a bad trend that has become, you know, very difficult for others to get their daughter married off. See, in our society, it is very shameful to say that each and every boy has price tag with him. So if your boy is a clerk, if your boy is a clerk, his rate is, he has fixed his own rate in a matrimonial market. 1 lakh has to be given as a dowry. If your boy is a manager, then he is demanding 5 lakhs. If your boy is a doctor, then he is asking for 10 lakhs or, you know, that is some luxurious cars and sometimes bungalows. Sometimes they ask for moon. So likewise, each and every, you know, boy has got price tag with it, and they are simply demanding money from their in-laws. That is the shameful thing. See, Mahatma Gandhi says, when a young man accepts dowry from their in-laws, it means that he is not only discrediting his education, but also he is dishonoring women. It is dishonoring women. Is she an object? It is something like a cattle market. You are going to a cattle market and you are purchasing a goat or a cow like this. And you are purchasing it. Not you are purchasing, they are giving money to purchase. How justice it would be? Is it justice? Just think. So, in this context, you know, our society is simply, you know, we are losing our values. We are losing our values. All literate and illiterates, they both behave in the same way. Even, you know, in the literary circle also, domestic tortures takes place only because of dowry. What they do? Simply, you know, that is a groom's mother and groom's father, when they go for a talk with bride's parents, what they do? See, we want this, we want two-wheeler, we want four-wheeler, we want that much of amount, we want so much. And finally, they would say that, it is for whom we are asking? We are asking for your daughter. This is not for my son, it is your daughter. If you give all those things, she would enjoy all the benefits. See how intellectually they are begging. Right? They are not at all better than a beggars. And here the groom, what he does, he maintains a neutral stand. He becomes neutral. he would say, no, 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 I'm not all my parents, all my parents. Even at that juncture only, he would behave like this. And after all, he's asking indirectly through his parents. If he is really a man, if he is a man of honor, if he is a man of respect, if he really respects women, what he has to do? He must tell his parents that you must not ask anything from my in-laws. Right? But he is not doing like this, because he is also intentionally, he keeps quiet. Just he expects that the thing must get done. See, under this pressure, how many murders takes place? How many, burnings takes place? How many divorce takes place in our society? How many families got, separated only under the evil of dowry system? This is the social evil. Dear students, in this occasion, I would like to tell you one thing. If you really honor your women, if you really respect your women, remember one thing, you must not ask dowry from your in-laws. God has given you a courage, no? Aren't you talented? Aren't you capable enough? Can't you take care of him? Just imagine that when a girl get married, how many sacrifices she makes. She leaves her parents, she leaves her father, she leaves her mother, she leaves her brothers, she leaves her sisters. Why? She leaves her own house. That is where she is born and brought up. She spends the entire childhood. She leaves everything for you. Then she enters into your house and she begins a new life. How many sacrifices she makes? Some girls are really, they must be respected. Because they call your father as your father. They call your mother as your mother out of affection. And they start their new life. They do all sort of adjustments. They have sacrificed all their comforts and they are ready to face the new challenges of your life, and she supports you in your entire life. Who will do this? And she will become your partner. She will become your life companion. She faces all the ordeals, hardships, happiness, sorrow, everything equally she shares with you. And she undergoes all type of, conditions of life. For that, from that woman you are expecting money. It is very shameful. So remember, dear students, please don't beg. And don't ask your parents to beg on behalf of you. Don't make your parents your beggars, and don't you become a beggar. It is really, aggravate the situation in our society. Okay, if a bride's father, he by hook and crook, he adjusts and he gives you an amount. Just imagine what will happen to a poor people. From where they would amass all the wealth, all the money to get their daughter Mary off. Then what would be the result? So our marriage system, our merit system, it is very painfully I am registering this fact, our merit system makes marriages a complicated one and adultery a cheap one. Under this pressure, you know, the daughters, our daughters, goes in wrong route. Even sometimes their parents, they won't bother about it. Because when you ask them, see how your daughter is behaving, they simply ask, what can I do? That fellow is demanding that much of dowry, apart from all the jewels and all the rituals. From where I can get all the money? So there is no option is for me, then let her do as she wishes. This is the cry of our parents. So remember, you know, this dowry system is collapsing our entire society. That is why, you know, one additional information I would like to tell you. That is why the Islam has designed a beautiful way that a mehr, that it is called as dawa, D-O-W-E-R, dawa, or mehr system, you can see in Islam. It means that you have to pay the amount, right? A groom has to pay the amount, not brides. See how beautiful it is. You have to purchase it. See, generally, you know, general one thing is that if you purchase things from a shop, how you would keep it? If you give more amount, if you purchase, you know, valuables from a shop, if you give lakhs of rupees, if you purchase a car or whatever the ornaments, how you would safeguard it? Because I have given that much of money, so I have to take care of it. So you are carefully, you know, what you do, you preserve it. Whereas, if somebody is giving you something freely, will you really, you know, give importance to that particular thing? Because you don't know the value. You don't know the value because someone has given to you. You get it free of cost. When you get something free of cost, what we do? We are not giving importance to it because you do not know the pain behind that commodity. So remember one thing, that is, Islam says that pay mehr, then touch your bride. See, before your marriage solemnized, you have to fix a mehr, you have to fix a daya. This much of amount I am paying, that you have to pay, then get married, otherwise your marriage is invalid. So Islam says to give, not to take. This is for your information, I would like to tell you, just to keep it in mind. How beautiful system Islam has. So what I would like to tell you, dear students, you take pledge. You take pledge. Because, you know, you are spreading so many information on social network like Facebook and WhatsApp. Dear student, my humble appeal to you is that you must create a new, a platform in which you must say that I never accept dowry. I never accept dowry because I am a man. And likewise, even, you know, the girls also must start a movement like that. I never give dowry. I never give dowry. I never give dowry. So even in our India also, in 1961, Dowry Prohibition Act was enacted. But there are no stringent laws to control this system. That is the thing. We are not implementing it properly. So that is the lack of implementation causes so many problems in our society. Okay. So, dear student, that is, you read that essay completely and you must, you try to understand that concept. How under the label of dowry, women are being victimized. We must stop doing this. We must inculcate confident in our daughters that, right, you are not an object, you are also a subject. We should not fix a price tag for their marriage, but we must accept them. We must accept them. Okay? Yeah. Thank you very much. We shall meet in next class. Thank you.